Welcome to the Whiskey Vault.
I'm Daniel.
I'm Brooks.
And
I am...
So this is a whiskey. Oh yeah, by the way.
So I have it.
Rex is physically propped up from behind.
The allergies, man.
With like the legs of a tripod.
It's one of these situations where you step outside of your office.
Ugh.
Step one, step two.
Oh, jeez.
Sneezing constantly.
It doesn't affect me. I mean, it does. It didn't affect me like everybody else. My eyes itch a little.
Yeah.
That's it.
So I ran into the house. I got the nasal thing and the medicines. I can still taste fine.
Did you get the sleepy time version?
I don't know, man.
Are you going to fall asleep in the middle
my
of this?
My wife said the one with the green cap. So.
Sure. That sounds like
Zyrtec?
Zyrtec. Yeah.
We'll see.
You'll be fine. Look what I did yesterday.
Looks familiar. See, you
yank the skin off of my hand.
You get the big soft hands.
Yeah, it was.
Chestnut farm. I saw the thing and I was like, oh, that looks like a familiar bottle. I've never heard of this though.
Yeah, Chestnut Farms. This is a gift from, what's his?
Bottled and Bonds, Kentucky Straight Bourbon Whiskey.
Cat and Shane.
Go. Is Daniel in the distance?
Absurd titans of whiskey.
Rajnay and Shane Jeffcoat.
Cheers, you magnificent bastards.
At some point they're getting married out here, and I can't figure out what you give as a gift to somebody who sent you like 195 bottles of whiskey.
Give them this bottle.
Okay, so, ow, the clapping hurts now. I can't clap anymore.
We are creatures. I think we've established it pretty clearly at this point. We are creatures of habit whenever it comes to vault shoots.
Yeah.
Just going through the motions. You and your clap.
Ow!
And then you, oh, wait, are you wearing a necklace?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I thought, see.
Okay.
You were about to break the mold for a second, but you did not.
No.
You
put on
a necklace, yeah.
Okay. So this is clear... Spring Distilling Company,
okay.
Which doesn't really, it's actually Sazerac.
So Chestnut Farms is a different, it's just the brand it was
this
sourced?
This is Sazerac using their own distilleries to create a specialty brand.
Okay.
It's the same distillery that as that when you find Costco bourbon,
yeah,
right? That's same people doing this, right? Sazerac using, according to the internet, using Barton. 1792.
Oh yeah.
For a whiskey.
Okay. Right? So
now I don't have a problem with that.
So I'm expecting classic flavors.
Yeah. I also brought over the bottled and bond.
The 1792.
Barton to compare to it. Because here's the thing. To me.
I was trying not to step back. Go ahead.
I know you did it. To me, this is no different than, you know, all the various releases from Buffalo Trace that are simply just picking from the barrel selection they have in their house to create a different flavor profile.
Yeah.
Right?
Sure.
So, in my opinion, this is just another 1792, but with a specific flavor direction.
Sure.
Right? Or for another example, it could be Baker's, Booker's, Knob, right?
This is what I'm going to
do. So this is Chestnut.
Instead of the step back, I'm going to basic, same effect. I get some distance, but...
Distance. Readjusting the shirt.
Hey, look at that. Very classic bourbon flavors.
Yeah, who knew?
It's like a melting together. I'm not getting a lot of individual layering of flavors.
No, I am getting just that dusty note, though.
Yeah, there's this. There's corn note. To your point, it's kind of the dusty corn note. Then that sweet, sweetened honey tea note.
And then it sort of stops for a second.
And then the oak character... I think the oak character matured nicely. It became this aromatic.
Yeah, it's not dry wood note. It's a richness.
Yeah, and I wish I need to familiarize myself with more wood because the aromatic sandalwood, I don't think is a sandalwood note.
No.
But that kind of aromatic quality, I
can
figure out. Yeah, because it's beyond oakiness. It becomes a sweeter, more aromatic thing.
Try it. It's nice. And the aftertaste is like wood zingy.
Oh.
It's not overly sweet. I really like this.
This is a sweet. Hey, how you doing?
Yeah.
Hey,
how you doing?
What's up?
But not.
There's no gruffness.
There's no gruffness, but there's also it's not overly sugary.
Not overly. I would say it's on the sweet end of the spectrum, but it doesn't go so hard in that sweet direction.
The finish ends in just that light wood note that you were talking about, with a slight dusting of powdered sugar.
Oh, I see what you did there with the sweetness on the wood. Yeah. You ever sprinkle sugar on your wood?
Yes.
Slight dusting, just right here?
Just a slight dusting.
On that wood?
Yeah.
Then turn it into, like, make some rails?
That's what gives...
Some lines?
Yeah, that's what gives it all that nice ridged color.
Mm-hmm.
For the pleasure.
Let's compare it. for God damn it. Let's compare it. I'm trying to recall what 1792 is.
Well, the only bummer about this one, let me check for one more, because this is a single barrel.
Okay, yeah.
No, so,
as best as I can remember, 1792 has always been a very nice, competent bourbon, but there's no outliers there. It's once again following that traditional, trying to throw it right over home plate
all right,
flavor
this,
set.
This is not the bottled and bond version. But both the bottled and bond versions I have are single barrels.
Just nosed an empty glass.
Well done, sir.
There's some parallels. On the nose, I think I like the horse bottle better.
Oh, this is way more of the antique-y direction.
That's a bit drier.
For me. Yeah, it's drier.
Yeah.
Still has the same ending, though. It starts totally differently, but it has the same ending.
There's more similarity in the nose than on the taste. It is, on the whole, a drier whiskey for sure.
Yeah. I much prefer the Chestnut Farms.
I do, too. Nose and taste.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Across the board. All right. Well, we've learned something today. You're welcome.
Did we? What did we learn?
We like Chestnut Farms better than Barton 1792.
We didn't learn anything.
Even though it's probably Barton 1792.
We don't learn here. I'm going to learn how to say this name. Sertagildes.
Sure.
I think that's it. Sertagildes. A question for you, magnificent bastard. Does anyone know the history of the building of the Whiskey Academy and the surrounding area? It's such a badass lair that I'm just craving some info on what the building is. Was it purpose-built for the school and just looks cool? Is it an old monastery or what? Go to wizardacademy.org.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the short version is a lot of people have been starting to show up and not know those history things. You can watch back even on this channel, early episodes of tower walk-arounds.
Yeah.
But effectively, this was Woods when we all got here, 18 years ago now, roughly.
Thereabouts.
And it was built as a school for independent entrepreneurs called Wizard Academy, and it's sort of grown into that. So there's a for-profit side where our distillery is.
Yeah,
it's basically Hall.
The neighboring property is where we actually
Tuscan Hall Event Center, where we've done some things like the Bastards Ball, and Rex's office,
but
the Barrel House.
The Whiskey Vault is actually a property of the nonprofit 501c3 educational institution known as Wizard Academy.
This room is attached to the main tower.
And is it like a division? A segment of Wizard Academy is the Whiskey Sommelier program.
A school inside of Wizard Academy
is
Whiskey Marketing School.
There you go.
Yeah.
I think that back in my head, I was thinking, come on, 1792. You know why? Because they gave us that wealth of hilarity and tragedy
with the barrel collapse.
With the collapse.
Yeah. You want them to win. Yeah. Well, they did win. Either way, they win.
Fair, yeah.
Because it's still them.
I guess.
So it's hard. They played against themselves in a game of chess and won.
You played yourself, 1792. Justin Ta, I've lost track after all these years. Which one is the psalm? It's the Flava Flav guy.
Yeah, no, you can spot a psalm because of their backup band and hype man that stands in the corner all the time. What?
I need to wear my Elvis cape.
Yeah.
it's you know, not a disappointment. It's not blowing my mind, though.
Right.
Yeah.
Just classic.
Here's to fighting, steal, and drinking.
If you fight, may you fight for a friend.
Steal, may you steal your lover's.
And if you drink, may you drink with us.
Batman,
Bottle Lord. This is totally not the second time we're recording this because I forgot to hit the button. Wait, Gary Wiley.
Gary,
look, clearly
it's dark.
It's dark.
Clearly says Gregory Wiles.
Look, can you see that from here?
Gregory, I'm so sorry.
You're a bottle lord.
Bottle lord.